Here are 8 features to watch out for in elementary OS 8. Before we move on to that, let me give you a quick background on elementary OS 8. It is one of the most beautiful Linux distributions based on Ubuntu 24.04 LTS. If you are someone who likes the design style of Apple's macOS, you should like this one. This is Ankush from Mitzfors, and let's take a look at the interesting feature changes in elementary OS 8. First one, the reworked welcome screen. This is the best part of the onboarding experience, and with this release, it has been tweaked for better keyboard navigation, screen reader compatibility. You can set some essential defaults here and get started. Second, lock screen refinements. There's nothing too big here, but the lock screen uses a bigger and bolder font along with the background wallpaper blurred out. Third, quick settings refinements. The quick settings feature more options to facilitate better accessibility. You can toggle on-screen keyboard, screen reader, and adjust font size as well. Fourth, system settings redesigned with a new icon. Just like the onboarding experience, the ability to change things and control the experience is also a big deal. This time, the system settings have been successfully ported to GTK 4 under the hood. Moving on to the visual side, you can find a new split pane view as shown in the video that makes things more accessible. It gives a cleaner look as well. It makes sense and looks more organized. Next, you can find changes to the appearance settings where you can preview the wallpaper and its dim variant. Fifth, OS updates and other component updates. With elementary OS 8, you can find available system updates from within the system settings. You also have the option to enable automatic updates, which is neat to have. In addition, the driver management has earned a spot here, just like the system updates. In earlier elementary OS versions, the AppCenter or the Software Center was where you could find the updates for the OS. So now it is much more useful and should make things more reliable. Sixth, AppCenter as Flatpak only. With updates and drivers moved to the system settings, the AppCenter is entirely Flatpak only. Not just limited to AppCenter's own Flatpak repo, it also comes with FlatHub as a source enabled by default. And I like this choice. New users should not have trouble finding all the essential apps for Linux while also giving them a Flatpak-only experience, particularly if you do not like using dev packages or Snap. Seventh, multitasking view. The new multitasking view is in harmony with the new dock, making it easy to switch to different workspaces even if you are not using gestures. As you can also notice, the background of the multitasking view blurs the wallpaper when you launch into the mode. Last and the eighth feature is VLAN and a new dock. The dock was rebuilt as a VLAN first experience featuring new animations in the mix for both the sessions. A little late to the party by elementary OS 8, but it finally embraces VLAN display server as its default. What do you think about elementary OS 8? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below.